Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the problem of real analysis from CSIR NET June 2019. Example number 31 from booklet C, Mass 3. Which of the following is true? First option, sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n divided by n does not converge. Second option, sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon n converges. Third option, sigma m equal to 1 to infinity sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon m plus n power 2 converges. And the fourth option, same series diverges. So it's a problem of convergence and divergence of series. So first we recall important test which we are going to use to check the convergence of each series. First is comparison test. Let sigma an and sigma bn are positive term series. If limit n tends to infinity, an upon bn is finite and non-zero, then both the series converge and diverge simultaneously. Second test, p-test series. For the positive term series, series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon n power p is convergent series if p greater than 1. Otherwise, that means p less than equal to 1, it is divergent series. Third test, alternating series test or limitless test. If the given series is alternating series, that means sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n a n is convergent if modulus a n is monotonically decreasing, that means modulus a n plus 1 less than equal to modulus a n, and limit n tends to infinity a n equal to 0. If these two conditions satisfy by alternating series, then series is convergent series. Option 1, which is minus 1 power n divided by n, which is alternating series, it's compared with the standard form, then an is equal to 1 by n. Therefore, an plus 1 is equal to 1 upon n plus 1. Since n less than n plus 1, 1 upon an plus 1 less, and modulus an plus 1 less than an, which satisfy the first condition, monotonically decreasing. Limit n tends to infinity, an equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 upon n, as n tends to infinity 1 upon n tends to 0. So an approaches to 0 as n tends to infinity, so it satisfies the second condition. So by the limitless test, this series is convergent, and the first option says that does not converge, so first option is wrong. Now for option 2, we will use the p series test. Here an equal to 1 by n, so it compares with the p test is n power p, so p is equal to 1. If p is equal to 1, then by the p test it is divergent series, but in the option it is given convergent series, so it is wrong. Option 3 and 4 have the same series, sigma m equal to 1 to infinity sigma n equal to 1 to infinity 1 upon m plus n power 2. So first we open the first summation by putting the value of n. So if we put n equal to 1, first term 1 upon m plus 1 power 2, second term 1 upon m plus 2 power 2, third term 1 upon m plus 3 power 2. Now apply summation on each term. Now after open the each summation, if you put m equal to 1, then we have first term 1 upon 1 plus 1 power 2, so 2 square. Second term m equal to 2, so 1 upon 3 square. Third term m equal to 3, so 1 upon 4 square, and continue. If you open the second summation, then m equal to 1, so first term is 1 upon 1 plus 2, which is 3, so 3 square. Then second term, if you put 2, then 1 upon 4 square, and continue. If you open the third summation, then it begin with m equal to 1, so it begin with the 4, 1 upon 4 square plus 1 upon 5 square plus 1 upon 6 square, continue. Now 1 upon 2 square comes only single time in all the terms. So first term is 1 upon 2 square. Now 1 upon 3 square comes only 2 times. 1 upon 4 square comes only 3 times. 1 upon 5 square comes only 4 times, and continue. If we rewrite, then we have 1 upon 2 square plus 2 upon 3 square plus 3 upon 4 square plus 4 upon 5 square. And in another way, in the series form, sigma n equal to 1 to infinity, it is n upon n plus 1 power 2. Now this series convert into the single summation. n equal to 1 to infinity n divided by n plus 1 power 2. So here an equal to n upon n plus 1 power 2. Now we consider bn is equal to 1 upon n. Now by taking the ratio limit n tends to infinity an upon bn, then we have n square divided by n plus 1 whole square, divide numerator and denominator by n square and apply as n tends to infinity we have 1 upon 1 plus 0, because as n tends to infinity 1 upon n tends to 0, then its value is 1, which is finite and non-zero. By the comparison test, an and bn converges and diverges simultaneously. Since bn is divergent series, by the p test we already discussed in the second option, so bn is divergent, so an must be divergent series. The option is wrong and the fourth option is correct. Thanks for watching. For more videos, like, share, subscribe, press the bell icon of NextGenMaths.